I'm John McGilchrist, chairman of Teaneck's Patriotic Observance Advisory Board. I'm a Vietnam veteran and a retired lieutenant colonel, United States Army Reserve. This year, because of the coronavirus pandemic, we are dedicating this observance to Teaneck's first responders, the staff at Holy Name Hospital, and all Teaneck residents who have been adversely affected by this terrible pandemic. Traditionally, we begin with the Pledge of Allegiance. This year, we're honored to have our town manager, Dean Kaczynski, lead us in the pledge. The pledge will be followed by the national anthem, followed by the invocation, this year delivered by Reverend Mays, chaplain of Teaneck's Police Department.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Greetings. The last several weeks has reminded us the reality of warfare. The COVID-19 pandemic has required Americans to battle an unconventional enemy. This enemy lurks invisibly among us, looking for the opportunity to destroy our lives. Like all wars, there have been casualties, suffering, and exhaustion by those in the front line. However, the people within our township have shown a great resolve in their ability to fight back against this terrible virus. War is never easy. However, it's necessary for the continued freedom we all enjoy and our future as a nation. Today, we remember men and women who fought enemies that were trying to destroy the liberties and the opportunities that make this country great. History has taught us that the resolve of a people is motivated by what they believe in and are willing to die for. During times of war, American men and women prepared themselves to battle different enemies through relentless sacrifice, commitment, and enormous resolve. Some lost their lives to the enemy, providing freedom and victory for many who would benefit for their ultimate sacrifice. We want to remember the many courageous lives that died through the wars our nation fought in. It's important to publicly recognize and honor them so that our children and their children will never take for granted the ultimate sacrifice of laying down a life for someone else. This is what makes our country both unique and great. God bless you.
This year, we will not be reading the list of Teaneck's honored dead, our gold star list. We must never forget them. They gave their lives in defense of the United States. In addition to them, however, this year we honor all those souls who have passed as a result of this COVID-19 pandemic. We keep them in our prayers. We also pray for those who are still in Holy Name Hospital fighting this pandemic And unfortunately, all those who we will lose in future days, we honor them all by sounding taps. My privilege to present to you the Township Mayor, the Honorable Mohammed Hamidideen.
Hello, this is Mayor Mohammed Hamidideen. On behalf of the Teaneck Township Council and the Township of Teaneck, I'd like to wish everyone a happy, healthy, and safe Memorial Day weekend. Today is the day that we honor the over 1 million uniformed soldiers who paid the ultimate sacrifice so that we could enjoy the freedoms of life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. This year is a little different. This year is not the usual beaches and barbecues that we're used to. We have to socially distance and make sure that we're safe from one another. But that does not mean that we don't honor the sacrifices of the brave men and women from the time of the Revolutionary War to present day conflicts who paid the ultimate sacrifice so that we could enjoy the life that we have today. I wish you all a safe and healthy Memorial Day weekend, a safe and healthy summer of 2020, and together we can all get through the pandemic of 2020. Thank you very much.
Our next speaker is no stranger to Teaneck. He is Larry Robinson, our town historian. Larry is a veteran of the United States Army, a retired captain of Teaneck's Fire Department, and a life member of the Ambulance Corps.
Hi, I'm Larry Robinson. I'm the township historian. Also have experience in the fire department and the ambulance corps here. And this year for Memorial Day, we're departing from our normal routine of thinking about the military veterans who gave their all for our country and for Teaneck. And this year we're remembering the first responders. Our first responders have been encountering dangerous conditions since this COVID emergency started. It's not just medical calls. Medical calls are very, very concerning. But even in routine fire alarm response, burglar alarm response, family disturbances, all the routine emergencies that happen around the clock every day here at Teaneck all have a hidden danger of COVID as well. So while we're thinking about them, I was thinking about some of the township first responders who in past years either gave their lives or were seriously permanently injured doing what they were doing to protect others. And my first thought was of the police department, where there were four line of duty deaths among the sworn officers. Clifton Dwyer was killed in the line of duty on 14 March 1926 in a motorcycle accident in the River Road and Martens Avenue. John Abraham was killed on 25 October 2010 in a traffic accident with a police car right across the street from this building. Robert Lee Fisher died on 19 April 1996 from gunshot wounds when he encountered an armed robber. And Sergeant Eugene Deckard died 11 February 1957 from a heart attack while on duty. The fire department also had one death and some significant injuries that I'd like to remember. First one was firefighter Henry K. Dorman, who in 1926 responded with his Company 3, to a fire in Holy Name Hospital construction site. Ran up the ramp while the rest of the members of his company were stretching a hose up. Big labor effort to get the line up there. Used a fire extinguisher that he found at the site, placed there by the contractor. The fire extinguisher nozzle was plugged, and so when he activated it, it exploded and filled his chest with fragments of brass shell of the extinguisher and the acid that was used to make the chemicals to propel the water from the extinguisher. That was the second time he got injured at a significant fire. And I'd also like to remember Floyd Farron. Floyd Farron was also a firefighter in Engine Company 3, or Hose Company 3 at the time. In 1930, he was in his car on DeGore Avenue and came upon a fire in a house at DeGore and Hickory. Fire department was not there yet. The neighbors were running with a ladder from somebody's backyard and said there was a woman trapped in the second floor front bedroom. He raised the ladder, went up on the porch roof. The woman was very, very big and very heavy and stuck in the window. As he was trying to pull her to safety, the fire flashed over in the room and the flame came out and burned his eyes, and he lost his sight for the rest of his life. I'd like to also remember firefighter Leroy Kirk. Firefighter Kirk and I worked together for a few years, and he died in September 1972 of a heart attack after a basement fire on King's Court in extreme humidity and heat. And I'd also like to remember Dr. Barnard Bookstaver. Dr. Bookstaver was the town police and fire surgeon. He was also the person who helped the ambulance corps get started because he started the training program there that far exceeded national standards. One very hot August day, where St. Anastasia's School is and was, at 1135 Teaneck Road, the old school caught on fire. The old school was made of wood and had been former military buildings from World War I. The new school had just been finished, the one that's now a charter school that's in front of it. Fire department came in and it made a major effort to save the new school. The old school was burning very vigorously. Dr. Bookstaver set up with the ambulance corps and the fire department rescue company on Overlook Avenue for the medical fire standby. And in the stress and the heat, he died of a heart attack on the job right there. We also have to remember the DPW, because the DPW many times really serves the role of first responder, because if they can't clear the streets of debris and trees and snow, then the other emergency services can't get there. So Frank Kilmurray was the superintendent of public works about 1994, and he had two major emergencies going on. The main trunk sewer had collapsed on Teaneck Road opposite Robinson Street, and he had a DPW worker posted there 24/7 for several days with a large pump, pumping the sewage around the break so it didn't spread into people's basements. Meanwhile, a big ice storm happened and trees fell down all over the place. So he was bouncing back and forth between the sewer emergency and the tree emergencies. He arrived at the scene where at Cherry Lane and Prince Street, where a large tree crashed down into a house, and his members were trying to cut the debris up and get the tree out of there. He collapsed in the street because he hadn't eaten. He was brought to Holy Name Hospital right away by the ambulance corps, and unfortunately his blood sugar had fallen so much he couldn't be saved. The ambulance corps itself, they've been taking big risks. They've had some members infected with COVID. Thank God they've all recovered. But the hazard still remains. And I'd like to remember one ambulance corps member who did one of the bravest things I've ever seen. His name was Randy Springer. He was a T-neck volunteer ambulance corps EMT. And for his paid job, he was a commercial diver. Well, in January 1974, an 11-year-old child tried to cross the ice that covered the golf course pond in the Overpeck Park golf course. The ice broke under the child, and his friends, instead of getting nearby help, ran all the way to Englewood to tell the child's mother. Eventually, the call came in, both the fire department and ambulance corps responded, and the water was frozen. But Randy Springer stripped off a couple of layers of clothing and dove into the water to try and find a submerged child. Firefighter Burns, Robert Burns, also waded in, which was also a dangerous and difficult thing, while other firefighters obtained a boat and sought to search with hooks. Well, they eventually found the child, but unfortunately he couldn't be saved. He'd been in the water too long. But Randy Springer, Tina Gamble School volunteer, was unable to work as a commercial diver ever again because of cold injuries to his lungs. So as we think about the current dangers, we also have to remember the past dangers. And just like with the military, some gave all and all gave some. Thank you. Now I'd like to introduce Teaneck Police Officer Kevin Florio, who besides being a Teaneck Police Officer is also a military veteran and is going to give us his thoughts about Memorial Day.
Hi everybody, my name is Kevin Florio. I've been a police officer with the Teaneck Police Department for almost 3 years now. And prior to my time serving the township, I served on a bit of a larger scale in the U.S. Army, where I spent 4 years in active duty service. And because of that, I've been asked to discuss some of the thoughts and feelings I have regarding the upcoming holiday of Memorial Day, which is something that I'm very happy to do. So, you know, just a little bit about myself. Graduated high school in 2008. 2 weeks after graduation, I was shipped down south to Georgia, where I attended basic training at Fort Benning, and also attended infantry school down there before eventually being assigned to a unit called the 10th Mountain Division, which is a very prestigious unit within the whole of the U.S. military and somewhere I was very lucky and honored to be a part of. So while with that unit, we deployed to Iraq in October of 2009, where I spent 11 months. And then I eventually left the Army in October of 2011. So Memorial Day is a holiday that has very profound meaning to me and most other veterans like me. And, you know, that is because Memorial Day is meant as a way to celebrate those veterans that were not as lucky as I am to come home, who answered the call of duty and made the ultimate sacrifice for this country. And those people are the true heroes, and those people are the ones who deserve to be remembered in that light. And the way I live my life is being that I was one of those who were lucky enough to make it back and knowing that so many didn't, I try and fashion my life in a way that would make those people proud. And I continue to do that. It's always in the back of my mind. And, you know, I think it's important to keep that in everybody's mind while they're out enjoying this holiday. And I hope you can find a way to enjoy it. I hope the weather's nice. I hope you can have a nice barbecue with your family the best you can under the current circumstances. Hopefully get some hot dogs and burgers on the grill and practice your social distancing. And hopefully you find a way to enjoy a bit of normalcy and a bit of quality time with your family and you know, during that time, I just ask that you keep that thought in the back of your head about why we're having this holiday, who it is truly for, and just be thankful as I am of the fact that throughout this country's history, there's always been people willing to step up and, if necessary, make the ultimate sacrifice in order to ensure that you and I and our families can continue to live in peace and prosperity. And so that's pretty much it. If you see me around town, feel free to say hi. I wish everyone the best of health, and I hope everybody can find a way to get through this. And as a community, I know that we will. So God bless. Happy Memorial Day. Thank you very much.
I'd like to read you Psalm 121, 1 through 8, as our benediction. I lift up my eyes to the hills. From where does my help come from? My help comes from the Lord, who made heaven and earth. He will not let your foot be moved. He will keep you, will not slumber. Behold, he who keeps Israel will neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord is your keeper. The Lord is your shade on your right hand. The sun shall not strike you by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord will keep you from all evil. He will keep your life. The Lord will keep you going out and coming in from this time forth and forevermore. Heavenly Father, we thank you for your guidance and for your protection. And Lord, as a nation, we ask for your divine help at this time. We are so grateful, Lord, for the men and women who sacrificed their lives for us so that we may enjoy the freedoms. And part of that freedom is to recognize and honor you. And so, God, during this period of time, we ask for your divine help. Overshadow us, Lord, with your presence and with your peace. And Lord, bring a sense of comfort and security to those who have lost loved ones during this period of time. We thank you that you hear us and that you will protect us if we turn to you. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. May God bless you.
This concludes this year's observance. Be safe, keep fighting, and may God bless Teaneck and all of its residents.
Oh, God bless America, land that I love. Stand beside her and guide her through the night with the light from above. From the mountains to the prairies,